You are now watching Rico TV.
Yes, sir. Do you have any problem with the videographer?
No, I don't.
Okay, perfect. I wanted to,
Is going to be the festival. It's going to start at 10 o'clock in the morning and at 10 o'clock at night. We already have Crazy Leg, Godfather Breakdancing coming. So they're going to kind of all be incorporated into it. Then we have a whole laundry list of local artists in the pay-to-play competition, as well as local DJs that are going to be coming out. We're going to be doing workshops with, graphic-type workshops with graphic design artists and artist placement type workshops and learning, teaching audio engineering. We're also partnering, hopefully, with the Boys and Girls Club. We're waiting on the finalization for that, coming up very soon. Whenever we get that, we'll be able to tout them. And of course, they want me to come out and do a whole bunch. They just made a new studio out there. I was wondering if the school would like to be interested in bringing interns out as well to that studio, kind
at
of
the
teach.
Boys and Girls Club.
It would kind of be a thing as teaching these boys and girls how to run audio equipment.
Yeah.
They'd like me to be the one that heads up that program. Basically, where we're at with it right now is auditions got pushed back.
Right.
We were going to be doing it, but the hurricane came, which was a great thing actually, because we wanted a whole bunch more pay-to-play artists to be signed up, which we have the opportunity to do. Now. They have to be top of the line and no cussing. It's a family-friendly event, so we've covered all grounds. The festival is going to be held at the H2O Church. That's the old 8 Seconds,
right,
down 100 West Livingston Street,
yeah,
downtown Orlando. We're going to be using the inside and outside of the venue. So we have, that going on. We're going to be running both stages simultaneously. Workshops going on during the whole day. A whole bunch of vendors, raffles going on. It's going to be a really great opportunity for especially college students.
Yeah,
are going to be very heavily marketed to. We have the UCF dance squad dweebs that have been on the television shows or whatever. They're coming out. The dance troupe is coming out. I'm trying to get a few colleges out
there.
What's
the actual event?
The event is October 22nd.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So, but like I say, you being my college that I graduated from, I really like to put you guys in the forefront as far as banners and so on, etc. But if you were able to provide me a certain amount of students for the day of the festival, for early in the morning for break, for setup of the stage,
sure,
sound. I'm in very tight with Jared, the owner of Central Florida Music Productions, running the sound. I'm very tight with Dennis Franklin, who's running the stages. So if you offer me these students, I'll be able to get them in there and get them in the know about a lot of live sound, which live sound was always something that I really wanted to
right,
embark on,
yeah,
but wasn't really given too much of an opportunity.
Right.
This is a fantastic opportunity for your students to get out there and do that live sound.
Yeah, how many students do you think that you need?
Mm-hmm. How many could you provide me? 10 would be, 10 or 15, would be beautiful. That would be a beautiful number. That would really take a load off of the workers that are going to be there. That would, the jazz festival's going on this exact same day. We're going to gain demographic from people going downtown, the traffic. But we're going to be hitting all major media outlets as far as radio, television. We plan on getting on Bright House. We're going to be going to, the YouTube channels, all the internet.
Who's doing your commercials?
Rico is one of the ones that we have as far as our videographer for the behind the scenes.
By TSM Studios.
Okay.
Well, do you think that they'd be interested in a partnership with, as far as we promote them at the fest, put them on flyers, etc., all our promotional material on our websites, and then they'd be willing to film us a commercial in return? Do you think that could be worked out?
If you shoot us like the specs of the commercial, we can even shoot here. David is the man.
Fantastic. That's what I'm wanting to hear.
But basically, all we need for that is just like a script.
Right.
And, we voice it.
Do you think that your students would be interested in putting that kind of thing together?
As long as you have like an idea.
Okay.
As long as you have like a well formula, just sit down and jot it down.
Of course. And as much as that as we could leave in the students' hands, that's all.
The radio commercials are really easy.
I got the radio commercials on lock. I've made so many radio commercials for so many clubs downtown that have been on all the FM radio stations since.
I challenge you.
So I can handle that.
Cool.
But as far as the television commercials, definitely would like to outsource that to someone who would be interested in partnering. That's where we stand. What are any questions that you have?
Just specific dates. Like, if you have like a one sheet where you could just like recap. If you have like a recap of everything that you just gave me.
Okay.
So that way I don't have to commit it to memory. I have
right.
like a one sheet, and I can try to organize some stuff on our end.
Okay.
As far as like getting some interns out that way, trying to figure out about the, you know, the commercial, things like that, you know, that could be a benefit to you. That way I can talk to my staff and, you know, figure it out.
Well, I was also mentioning to Justin, what I think we should have is to be able to have First School have a vendor out there to be able to give people.
Oh, they're going to have a vendor.
Give people the know-how, you know,
right.
Because there's a lot of producers, you know, a lot of the people in the music industry. That try to do things.
You see this, what's the date of the event?
October 22nd. It's going to be an all-day event. Trying to cover every demographic from young to old. So we've gotten in the art demographic, the dancing demographic as far as Crazy Legs and with Dweebs being there, the dance troupe from UCF. We have a little teen sensation. His name is Brejay. He's going to be the next Justin Bieber. In a couple of years, you're going to know about
him. Is he a country guy?
At 14 years old, he is a teen sensation right now. He's done everything from like Waka Flocka stuff to, you know, he's in back with Marion or whatever.
Yeah.
You see, you go to his website, brejaymusic.com, you'll read up more about him. Links to all his page and plus videos up on the pages of him. We also have Chad B, who's featured on 106 and Park here just recently for his song Hit It.
Okay, cool.
So that's kind of the middle crowd, you know, the young hip crowd is
right.
going to be there with that. To remove the negative stigma associated with the hip-hop genre with this
right.
event, and I think Orlando's never seen anything like it before. That's why it's the first annual Orlando Hip-Hop Fest, and we're going to do the second annual coming up. So, you know,
that's
it's
awesome.
Going to be it's gonna be an annual thing, and Orlando's never seen anything like this,
cool.
and they never will again. So,
well, just give me that one sheet so that, you know, because you guys hit on a lot of things that
yes.
we might be able to assist on.
Of course.
So the more organized it is and the less time consuming it is for me,
exactly.
the easier it is and the more we've done. So.
Okay. Right. We plan on laying all that out for you in a very detailed, but I, like I said, face-to-face was the only way that we were really going to get you
sure.
in the know about this event.
Because it's coming up pretty fast, man. So
it's coming up.
Yeah,
we have all our ducks in a row. We aren't scared about the time frame that we have at all. You know, we're very well prepared. So.
After the event, have you come in and we'll do an interview like we do on all of our exceptional graduates.
Okay, fantastic. Yeah,
so.
I'm really expecting a very, very high community involvement in this.
Yes.
You know, the ticket sales as they are standing online are $10 for ticket sales online
wow.
for the festival. That's an amazing ticket price.
Right.
Tickets are definitely going to go up at the door.
you
know?
You guys doing flyers?
Yeah,
yeah.
The next couple of days. We wanted to wait till we had our headliners before we really invested in our,
yeah,
in our
yeah,
graphics
sure.
and everything.
Sure.
But with this press release, when it goes out here in the next couple of days, it's going to be like a bomb dropped on this
yeah.
festival.
Cool.
CBS Radio contact us. We've
yeah.
had BET contact
mm-hmm.
us. We've had Ludacris even tweeted to us about his charity
contact.
That he does in Atlanta, Georgia. He'd like to get
yeah.
for us to come to Atlanta
yeah.
and do a hip-hop festival.
Nice.
So. The amount of people that want to know about this without us even sending out a press release
yeah.
is amazing.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
That's
no
right.
more, and they don't even know who the headliners are.
Yeah.
It's going to be like, wow.
Well, anytime you put hip hop festival, it sounds pretty big.
Especially
yeah.
with
true.
Orlando's first annual
right.
hip hop festival. We picked a good name. I'll
yeah,
tell you
definitely.
That much right now. So yeah, it's going to be a fantastic event. I want to have the First School's name all over it.
That's great. So yeah, we'd love to be involved, you know, love to support you and see what we can do to, you know, make it happen.
Yeah, perfect.
You know, we're definitely
perfect.
Excited, man. I remember when you first came into the school, so we won't go into all
that.
We won't go into
can't
all
go
that,
into all that.
You know,
can't go into all that now.
But yeah, you know, I think that's awesome, man. So
fantastic.
I definitely want to help you out and hope, you know, make the first one help it become a success
yes.
and move on to... You know, until you get all the way down to your 10th annual.
Exactly. Hey, we were just speaking. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
exactly. I love to hear that. What's going on, Rico Television? Here with Basement Beats, and we got Keegan Trotman and Devon out.
How you doing?
We're here today in Full Sail University. Going to go up and speak to the admissions department about coming out and being a vendor with the Orlando's first annual Hip Hop Fest. So it should be a pretty nice little day speaking with the admissions counselors.
Let's do this.